Have you ever wondered why the color chip you brought home from the paint store looks completely different in your home? Well, I'd start by looking up. Lighting plays a massive part in the overall look of your wall color. Whether it's a different time of day or a different type of light bulb, the look of your room can change dramatically. I want to go over some of the key principles behind lighting and how it will impact your wall color. We'll discuss room exposures, and the impact of color temperature, so you'll be prepared to make the best possible color choices. I'm James from thepaintpeople.com, and we do several videos every single week on this channel, some about paint colors, and other videos that are more so about the technical side of painting. Whether you're a pro or an average Joe, we got you covered. When it comes to picking a color, the actual color on the chip isn't the be-all and end-all, because how it looks in a hardware store will be drastically different in your house with your lighting. Colors are not static. Even the most neutral looking colors are dynamic and can change quite a lot throughout the day depending on the surrounding lighting conditions. It's important to have a general understanding of lighting and its impact on the colors you choose. Natural light emitted from the sun changes throughout the day, while interior lighting changes based on what type of light bulb you buy. You may have heard the terms cool light and warm light. Your overhead office lighting will feel a lot more blue or cool than an older lamp using an incandescent light bulb. How we quantify this is with the Kelvin color temperature scale, usually notated by a number followed by the letter K. This ranges from candlelight, which is just under 2000 Kelvin, to warmer light bulbs around 3000 Kelvin, all the way to a bright blue, which is at 10,000 Kelvin. Historically, incandescent bulbs were most commonly used. As we transitioned to fluorescent and halogen lighting, that warm light became white, or even cool. Today, the technology of LED lighting gives you all the flexibility in the world. For example, I have this LED light that we use in our videos, and it's adjustable. So right now it's set to 6500, which is a very bright white. And then as I transition it to 3000 Kelvin, it becomes pretty yellow and warm. Whatever lights you're using or looking to purchase, you'll be able to find the estimated Kelvin value notated on the packaging. But keep in mind, these are just estimates. Natural light from the sun is the first thing you want to consider because you can't really change much about the sun. Natural sunlight is considered to represent a color the best, as it'll have minimal blue and orange tones mixing in with the wall color. It's the closest thing to neutral white light. And if you wanted to replicate this in your home, you can look for bulbs around the 5 to 6,000 Kelvin range. Another important consideration is where your room is in relation to the sun. North-facing rooms will tend to have a larger amount of cool, even bluish light. It does stay fairly consistent throughout the day, which is a plus, but I tend to recommend colors that are a bit bolder and lean towards the warmer side of things so that the cooler light will be neutralized a little bit. South-facing rooms take that to the extreme, so you'll have even brighter conditions. If you normally would opt for a light gray color, maybe go for a more mid-tone grayish with this type of exposure. Dark colors will feel brighter, so it could be a good opportunity to experiment with some more daring color choices. Because the sun rises in the east, east-facing rooms will have lots of warmer light in the morning, which will get cooler into the afternoon. You can use colors in the warm color palette to help complement the cool light. Western exposed rooms will have very bright light around the afternoon time, so I would steer you away from the warmer paint colors because they'll just be amped up and it could be a bit overwhelming. How about the light that you can control? The light that you use in your house has a huge impact on color. Incandescent light bulbs produce that warm orange light, which we talked about, and that will amplify any warm tones and soften any surrounding cooler paint colors. Fluorescent lighting will do the exact opposite. Any blues or greens will appear more saturated and brighter under this type of lighting. Halogen lighting is going to be a bit of a mix between the two. It'll appear closer to white, which will not only make colors appear brighter, but they'll also blend in to direct sunlight a bit better. The thing is, you don't always want bright sunlight, especially in the evening time. And that's where this LED technology shines. Not only can they be configured to appear warmer or cooler, but your phone or even modern smart bulbs can be controlled on demand wirelessly. This means you can simulate bright sunlight during the day and then adjust to a nice, cozy, warmer light in the evening. While having consistent lighting throughout your home is ideal, I've also seen people use an interesting mix of warm and cool lighting in specific areas. Warm lighting favors comfort, while cooler light favors productivity. So in areas like offices, kitchens, or even the garage, you can play with higher Kelvin bulbs and go with colors that will be complemented by that cooler light. If you are a bit apprehensive about picking a color because you're concerned about how it'll be impacted by the lighting in your home, you have a few options. The paint store that I use has a lighting slider right by all the color chips, and that allows you to simulate warmer room light and cooler sunlight. If you're still not convinced, the tried and true method is to bring the color home with you and put them on your wall, ideally next to something white like a door or a frame. Color chips are fine, but even better than that are color testers. They allow you to paint a large portion of the wall so you can get a strong sense of what the color will look like once it's been applied. If you want to pick up some testers, you can check out our link down below. And also, here's a little more detail on what they are. If you've made it this far, go ahead and subscribe if you haven't already. That's it for this one. See you on the next one.